Iben, thank you very much for joining me. I have three questions to ask you, and you have 1 minute each to answer each question. Thank you for joining me. And I would like to introduce a comparable book, a wonderful book, and Iben has a huge following on Instagram and social media, so please follow her. She has a wonderful message for all parents and educators all over the world, and I would like to say in particular in the US right now. All right, here we go. How much should we explain to our children about the coronavirus?
I will always go with the truth. And in this scary time, children need to know the truth about what is going on in age-appropriate way, of course. So their imagination doesn't run away with them and make them feel even more scared. So when you explain truthfully while remaining calm, they will have a solid foundation to lean onto and count on, which is extremely important for them to feel safe. But I will always also leave any conversation with some kind of positive output.
Second question, but we're all panicking and it's difficult to remain calm. Where should we put our focus?
It is essential to focus on coping with the stress that the coronavirus causes right now. Everyone reacts differently to stressful situations. So as much as possible, I think it's important to be your child's healthy role model right now. And that is creating moments of presence and read stories and play or do some cleaning together or some other activities that's not only on your child's premises. Children love to participate and just be close to you. And set some boundaries with flexibility and understanding in mind and do a lot of hygge. If you need support as well, I think it's important to reach out. That will only teach your child how to deal with the down periods later on in life.
Thank you. So another question for you, but it isn't always easy. Children pick up a lot and feel scared. So what can we do?
Yeah, many children will react with big feelings, which you must help them to work through. You can do that by acknowledging whatever they feel, hold them close, and listen to their questions and their fears. Do not point fingers or say that they can't feel whatever they are feeling. All feelings are equally reasonable, and this is a time where you can practice embracing even the more difficult ones. And always make sure to reassure you that you won't leave them alone and that everything will be good again. Because children need to know that the world is a good place for them to grow up and that people all over the world work hard to help the sick people get better. And if you feel terrified yourself, children don't benefit from adopting your big feelings. You should keep those to other adults to share with them. That's it.
Well, thank you so much, Iben. I hope we can continue to work together and continue the conversation.
Me too. That would be very nice.